subject name is financial accounting 2. In your first year, first sem, we learn the financial accounting 1. In second sem, financial accounting 2. Okay, the subject is for total is 100 marks. Under this 100 marks, 80 marks is final examination, and remaining 20 marks is internal examination. Okay, total is 100 marks. So under this financial accounting subject, total 5 units are there. Total 5 units. So under this subject, both as theoretical and practical knowledge of the topics will be there. Okay, now first we'll discuss the what are that 5 units. Okay, we'll discuss that 5 units. Okay, under that unit 1 is bills of exchange. Unit 1 is bills of exchange, and unit 2 is consignment accounts. Unit 2 is consignment accounts. Unit 3 is joint venture accounts. Unit 3 is joint venture accounts. Unit 4 is accounts from incomplete records. Accounts from incomplete records. Accounts from incomplete records. And unit 5 is accounting for non-profit organization. These are the total 5 units. Okay, now see what are that is. First unit name is bills of exchange. Unit 2 is consignment accounts. Unit 3 is joint venture accounts. Unit 4 is account from incomplete records. account from incomplete records, and unit 5 is accounting for non-profit organizations. Now first we'll discuss just introduction of all these 5 units. Next we will go through the unit 1. Okay, so generally bills of exchange means a bill of exchange is an instrument in writing containing an unconditional order signed by the maker directing a certain person to pay a certain sum of money only to or to the order of a certain person to the bearer of the instrument. Okay, so this bills of exchange is what it is, one type of an instrument. In that instrument we are writing, okay, and so on, I am giving 10,000 rupees to some persons on this day, and this I will take the money after 3 months. Like this, it must be in writing and it must be signed by the maker. Maker means who is preparing this bills of exchange is signed by the maker, and it must be an unconditional order. Condition means we have to put some conditions. Unconditional means there was no conditions in order to pay. Okay, so under this bills of exchange, it is an arrangement where the creditor gets the documentary evidence of the amount owing and also the terms of payment. Suppose I'll say one example for this bills of exchange. Suppose A, B, two parties are there. A sells goods to B. A sells goods to B for rupees 1,000 on credit. Credit means immediately we will receive cash. No, immediately we receive the cash, then it is an a cash transaction. Suppose credit transaction means we will receive the money in the future, or receives the money in the period of 10 days or 15 days based upon these parties. Okay, A sells goods to B rupees 1,000 on credit, not receiving immediately cash. Okay, A will receive the amount in the future. In order to acknowledge the debt that exists between them, okay, here A is what? Here A is the creditor. Here A is the creditor, B is the debtor. So now see here, A gives now, B is owes to the A, because in future A receives money from the B. So A is a creditor, B is a debtor, B will give its amount to A. Now here, so on credit now, in future we will receive the amount. If in case A will not receive any cash from the B, then what is the situation? A lost the goods now. So that's why, for not losing any goods, A wants to prepare this bills of exchange statement, or it is an one type of an document. So that's why for the credit transaction, A writes out a bills of exchange and sends it to the B. The languages of the bills of exchange is such that it required to B to pay 1,000 to A at a fixed or determinable future time. Okay, suppose A sells goods to B, A will give the amount within 20 days or uncertain date. Suppose on 15th January 2017, sales goods to B gives the amount to A on 26 January 2005. And on this date, A will pay amount to A. After receiving the bill, B signs his name across the face of the bill, maybe within the word accepted. Suppose, so for example, say it is an example only. It is an one type of an a bills of exchange. Okay, so here on the credit side is place name is Hyderabad and date is 15th Jan 2017. So here I am writing the how much is the amount, rupees 1000. Okay, rupees 1000. How many days? Suppose 10 days or okay, 10 days after, 10 days after date to bear a sum of rupees. Sum of rupees 1000. Okay, for value received. Okay, here stamp is there na? Here make the stamp. Here write the A signature. Okay, write it. After preparing these bills of exchange, A will send to this bill to B. After receiving these bills of exchange, B is signed as the bills of exchange as sign is accepted. Here B will make the sign is accepted, means this bill is accepted. Definitely I will pay 1000 rupees on this certain date. If any cases B did not pay the any amount, then A can sue the amount or A can file a case against the B. Okay, it is an a bills of exchange. Okay, under this bills of exchange, there are three parties are there. Okay, under this bills of exchange, there are three parties are there. One is drawer and one is drawee and next person is payee. This will be discussing while going into the classes. Okay, today we'll just know the introduction part. Okay, next under this, so when was the Negotiable Instrument Act? Negotiable Instrument Act is 1881. Remember that year is Negotiable Instrument Act is 1881. It states the under this Negotiable Instrument Act only there is an bills of exchange, promissory notes, checks will be there. Then what are the accommodation bills? Accommodation bills means these bills are drawn and accepted without any consideration. Consideration means amount or money. Without means they did not include any money. Okay, these accommodation bills are drawn and accepted without any consideration, just to give the financial support to one or both the parties. So these accommodation bills are also known as an kite bills. Okay, so in that bills of exchange there are some journal entries are there. Okay, the journal entries are, we will write in the books of drawer, in the books of drawee, okay, in the books of payee. Okay, so it is very, very easy. Okay, Under this first unit only journal entries are there. Just we have to write the journal entries in the two types of books. It is an a first unit. Then second unit is consignment accounts. Consignment means consign. Consignment, generally meaning of consignment is what? Sending. Okay. Consignment means sending of goods from one person to another person, or from one country to another country, or one country or abroad for the purpose of storage and then ultimate sale on commission basis at the risk of the sender himself. So, in simple words, consignment means where one person sends goods to send goods to another person where one person sends goods to another person to be sold on commission basis. Consign means what? Sending goods. Okay. Consignment means sending of where one person send goods to the another person to be sold on the commission basis. Or consignment business is an extension to the direct sales system. Means unlike direct sales or indirect sales are made through an agent. Okay, under this consignment we sold the goods through the third party or goods through an agent who is appointed on a commission basis. For any one person is appointed, for that person is mainly based on the commission basis. So this system of indirect selling is known as an consignment. Now see, for example, A, B customer, or this customer is say C. Okay, now see, here the person or firm sending the goods is called as an a consignor. Here A is a person, this person sending the goods to B. For this person is known as an a consignor. Got it? The person or the firm, here A is the person sending the goods, is called as an a principal or consignor. The person who receives the goods, here B receives the goods. Here B is called as an a consignee. Called as an a consignee or agent. Okay. Now B sold the goods to the customers. Okay, it is an indirectly na. For suppose direct sales means what? A directly sold goods to the C, it is an directly. But this consignment is done on the indirectly. First A did not sold the goods, just sending the goods to B, for these goods are sold to the customers. Suppose if your goods are all are sold at a time, I will give some commission to you. Suppose 500 units are sent to B. Then what A said that, suppose you are sold these 500 units within 5 days, then I will give you 2% commission on this amount. Okay, so after selling the goods, A will give some commission to the B. Here B is a consignor or a agent through the third party, through the, so this consignment means what, the goods are sold the indirectly. Okay, A will send goods na, that's why A is called as an a consignor. Here who receives the goods, B is a receives the goods, so B is called as an a consignee or agent. After receiving the goods, then the B's are sold goods to any customers who are the interested to buy that sales, then B will be sell. Suppose goods are not sold by B, then B will return that goods to A. So this is the meaning of consignment. In consignment, the relationship between consignor and consignee, here some relationship is formed, so that relationship is called as an, the relationship between consignor and consignee is called as an a principal and agent relationship. Okay, in this consignment accounts also we'll do the problems, or else we want to write a journal entries also. We'll write the journal entries in the books of consignor and in the books of consignee. After writing the journal entries, if any stock is there, we find out that the remaining stock, if any stock is any dispatch by the transportation, or sometimes any loss is there, sometimes suppose A will send goods to B, for this process A incur some delivery charges, some expenses, for that expenses also we will write the journal entries. Okay, under the second unit also we will write the journal entries in the books of consignor and in the books of consignee. After writing journal entries, we will find the any unsold stock is there, we will calculate that unsold stock. Okay, this is second unit. Next, third unit is joint venture. Next is joint venture. Joint venture means joint venture is undertaken by two or more person jointly for earning profit. It's just like a partnership. Okay, so under this joint venture, it is usually a temporary partnership. Okay, in that joint venture, without the use of firm name, limited to carrying out any particular business plan, in which the persons concerned agree to contribute capital, at the end how much profit or loss is getting, they will share. Okay, now see example is, for example for this joint venture is, suppose in newspaper given is an advertisement is what is like if any one person has interested to build a building with the amount of rupees 50 lakhs, okay, within a period of 3 months, okay, after giving advertisement in newspaper, on one day X read that in newspaper, X see that advertisement in the newspaper, okay, so how much is that rate of building is 5 lakhs for build a building in within 6 months X saw that advertisement, but so for example X have this 50 lakhs, then directly X will go and talk with that contractor, will take this, okay, after that within 6 months X will build that building and give to him. At the end, how much his profit is or loss is getting, he only taken. For example, X does not have capital of 50 lakhs. X have only 25 lakhs. But how much needs total 50 lakhs? And one friend is there, X friend is Y. A will have 25 lakhs. These two persons have combined together and will take that venture. That venture will be completed within 6 months. Okay, after completing the 6 months, how much they paid? 50 lakhs. So when they are paid starting, that is completed. After 6 months, these X and Y persons are sell that building is rupees 60 lakhs. Sell that building is 60 lakhs. How much they sell extra? 10 lakhs. This 10 lakhs is profits to this person. After getting this profit, how much is getting profit? 10 lakhs. How much they are invested? 25 lakhs. 25 lakhs means half of the amount is invested. So how much is profit is getting? 10 lakhs. These 10 lakhs also share the half of X will get 5 lakhs profit and Y will get the 5 lakhs profit. Suppose this building is sold to some other person, they will share the profit. After they'll share this profit, the venture is closed, the venture is completed. This is the joint venture. Or in the joint venture, for example, is any roads construction, bridges construction, like that. If any big amounts, okay, two or more persons are combined together, put some invested, at the end any profit or loss is getting, they will share equally or based upon the ratios. Now see, sometimes to undertake a specific job or project or venture like construction of dams, bridges, construction of apartments, roads, underwriting of shares, debentures, etc., or buying and selling of goods for a particular season requires that huge funds, technical expertise, okay, for an individual it is not possible. Okay, for an individual the joint venture is not possible. The alternate available is what? Alternate available is two or more persons join hands, take such assignments. Joining hands may be for finance, for technical know-how, for sharing the risk, etc. When two or more persons join together to carry out a specific business and they shares the profits or predetermined loss. If any profit is getting, they will be shared. Anytime loss is getting, that also shared. So it is known as a joint venture. So the parties in joint venture are known as an co-venturers. Their liability is limited. Okay, who are the parties are involved in this joint venture is known as an a co-venturers, and their liability is limited. The next is, in this also we'll write the journal entries. Okay, so there are three ways of recording the joint venture transaction. One is separate set of books maintained for joint venture business. The next is recording joint venture transactions in the books of each co-venturer. The next is recording joint venture transactions in the books of each co-venturer under memorandum method. This is the third unit, is joint venture accounts. Next, fourth unit is accounts from incomplete records. Accounts from incomplete record. So when we in accounts, incomplete record means what? Single entry system. But whenever we, in the accounting point of view, we use a double entry system. Double entry system means there is a every debit, there is an a corresponding credit. Okay, but accounts from incomplete records in this unit, mainly we use the single entry system. Single entry system means every organization, whether trading or non-trading, prepares these financial statements at the end of each financial year. Okay, so those organizations which do not follow the double entry system also ascertain the operational results. Operational results means profit or loss, financial position. Financial position means balance sheet through the single entry system. Small businesses, concerns which are not familiar with the double entry bookkeeping system, follow this method. However, corporate bodies, companies, corporations, statutory bodies do not follow this single entry system. It is mandatory to follow double entry system, but in big businesses, big companies, they want to follow the definitely it is mandatory to follow the double entry system. But small businesses, small concerns have the follow this single entry system. Under the single entry system, single entry system is generally used to denote the method of maintaining the books of accounts which does not follow the principles of double entry system. According to the single entry system, generally the personal accounts of debtors, creditors are maintained, and the real accounts are not to be maintained in the books of accounts. Only personal accounts are maintained. Real accounts and nominal accounts are not to be maintained in the books of accounts. Personal accounts means, in that personal accounts we have to record the person's names. Okay, another personal account, there are three types will be there now. Natural personal account, representative personal account, artificial personal account. Only personal accounts are to be maintained. Then real accounts means, what are the real accounts? Are assets relating to the. Next, nominal accounts means any expenses, losses, incomes, gains. Okay, the real and the nominal accounts are not maintained in the books of accounts. Okay, under the single entry system, only one pro pharma is there. That pro pharma is how do we get the profit or loss. After getting profit or loss, we prepare the balance sheet, then the problem is completed. Okay, in the fourth unit there was no journal entries. We learn one method of pro pharma, this problem is completed. Very very easy topic is I come from incomplete records. Then last unit is accounting for non-profit organization. Accounting for non-profit organization. Non-profit organizations means generally organization can be classified into two categories. One is profit making organization and second one is non-profit making organization. Profit making is relating to the business. The main thinking is what the main aim is to earn more profits. And the non-profit making organization, the main aim of the primary objective of business organization is what? To earn profit through businesses. On the other hand, then what is the main objective of non-profit organization is to render services to the members. Okay, the main aim is what? Rendering services to the members. For the profit organization, the main aim is what? To earn profit through the business. But for this non-profit organization, the main aim is rendering services to the members, not an a profit. Okay, as these organizations do not undertake any trading activity for profit is called as an a non-trading concerns or not for profit organizations. Okay, so these non-profit organizations are can be divided into three categories. Can be divided into three categories. So that three categories are one is institutions which work for the general welfare of their members, means clubs, staff association, next is residential association, then second is charitable institutions. Charitable institutions means educational institutions, hospitals, etc. Then next is professional firms like chartered accountants, advocates, tax consultants, doctors. Okay, so this non-profit organization divided into these three categories. Okay, under this non-profit organization we have three different types of problems. What are the different three are? One is receipts and payment method problem. Okay, one method is receipts and payments account, and second is income and expenditure account. Then next is balance sheet. Okay, so each have individual pro formas. First, receipts and payments method one pro forma, and income and expenditure for one pro forma, and balance sheet for one pro forma. This is also very very easy. Okay, this is our first class is introduction of the financial accounting two. From the next class we will start the bills of exchange, that is unit 1.